Let's look at a few examples where we practice solving linear equations. Here's our first example. We have 3 equals 2 times the quantity y plus 5 minus 11. I assume we're already familiar with the steps to solve linear equations. If you're not, you can go back and watch our video on how to solve linear equations. But anyway, step 1 is to simplify both sides, which would require us to do things like distribute this 2 and possibly combine any like terms that we have. So we'll have 3 equals, 3 is already simplified, we'd have 3 equals 2y plus 10 minus 11, because 2 times y and 2 times 5, 2 times 5 makes 10. I see some like terms over here on the right hand side, plus 10 minus 11, so I have 3 equals 2y, and plus 10 minus 11, those are like terms, they're both constants, would give us minus 1. Once both sides are simplified, then we have to move the variables to one side of the equation and the constants to the other. Doesn't really matter which side you move them to. Since the y's are already on the right side, I think it would be easier to add 1 to both sides, which will remove the minus 1 from the right and put a plus 1 on the left, and minus 1 plus 1 cancel on the right. Keep in mind, you always have to do the opposite operation of whatever's done. If it's a minus 1, you have to add 1 to make it go away. If we subtracted an additional 1 from both sides, you get minus 2, not minus 1 on the right hand side. So it just gets worse. You have to do the opposite operation. So we get 4 equals 2y. And then last step, if you remember your steps, was to divide by the variable's coefficient. The variable y has a coefficient of 2. We'll divide both sides by 2, and we're done. We get an answer of y equals 2. 2 is the solution to this linear equation, and what that means is you should be able to take 2 and plug it back in any variable like y in the original equation, and it should make the left side really match the right side. And I'm not going to do this for all the examples, but I'll at least do it for the first one. Let's take 2 for y and try plugging it back in the original. 2 plus 5 makes 7. 7 times 2 makes 14. And 14 minus 11 really is 3. So I know 100% that this is the right solution. If I did not get equality here when you plug in for y, you'd have to check your algebra, make sure you combine the right terms and you had your positives and negatives correct and that sort of thing. Okay, here's the next example. 2 times the quantity z plus 4 minus 1 equals negative 3. So step 1, as before, was to simplify both sides. We'd have 2z plus 8 minus 1 equals negative 3. Then we'll combine any like terms, like the plus 8 and the minus 1 gives us plus 7 equals negative 3. Once both sides are simplified, like we have here, we'll move the variables to one side and the constants to the other. The variable z is already on the left, so we'll leave it alone and we'll subtract 7 from both sides, and that'll move the plus 7 to the right side and it'll become minus 7. Plus 7 and minus 7 cancel on the left, so we get 2z equals negative 3 minus 7 makes negative 10. And the last step, as always, is to divide by the variable's coefficient, and which is 2 in this case. The 2's will cancel and leave us with a final answer of z equals negative 5. Now, I'm just for time's sake, I'm not going to take this one and plug it back in. You can, and verify that it really does make the left side match the right side. All right, last example for this video is, let's try one with decimals in it. We haven't done any of these yet. Don't be afraid of decimals. The algebra is the exact same. You might have to add decimals or subtract decimals, but that's not a big deal. And if we need to, we can use our calculator as well. So step 1 is to simplify both sides. One thing I see is that we'll probably have to distribute this negative. So we'll have 0.31y minus y minus 1.71 because you're distributing the negative. Then on the right-hand side, we'd have 0.9 times 21. If you don't feel comfortable doing that by hand, then we'll just take our calculator here and do 0.9 times 21, and we'll get 18.9. All right, on the left-hand side, I still have a little bit to clean up. I have 0.31y minus y. Those are like terms. So I can just add or subtract the coefficients, and I can do that in the calculator. I actually don't need to type in the y's. I'm really just adding and subtracting the coefficients. So I have 0.31, and we'll just understand that it's that many y's that we have first, minus 1y that's coming second. And that'll leave us with a total of negative 0.69 y's when we combine them. So we just understand that we're combining y's. We just add or subtract the coefficients. Minus 1.71 equals 18.9. Very good. We simplified both sides. Now, as always, we'll move the variables to one side. The y's are already on the left, so we'll leave them there. We'll move the constants to the right-hand side, the opposite side. We'll do that by adding 1.71 to both sides. All right, and the reason, again, we do that is because it's the inverse, it's the opposite of subtracting 1.71. So they will cancel on the left-hand side, and we'll get negative 0.69y. Equal to, let's see, this will be, I'll skip the calculator for this one. I believe it's 20.61, if my algebra is correct. And then the last step, as always, is to divide by the variable's coefficient, negative 0.69. And I'll do that in the calculator as well. So I have 20.61. And if you have in this case, I could just type negative 0.69, but if you have a really long decimal, a nice shortcut that you might could use is you can click divide by second answer, and what that'll do is the calculator will go back and retrieve the previous answer, in this case negative 0.69. I know it's a little lazy, I could have just typed it in, but you can see why that would be helpful if it was a very long decimal. And go ahead and push enter, and we'll get negative 29.8695. We'll round this to negative 29.87. Negative 29.87. So we did round that. So this answer is technically an approximation because we rounded it. But basically, you should be able to take this for y and plug it back in all the y's in the original equation, and it should make the left side match the right side if done correctly.